I grew up in Milwaukee, Wisconsin. I was born in 1934 and lived in Wisconsin most of my childhood and part of my adult life. My mother and father came over from Poland at the turn of the century. And we did things together. We ate together, unlike a lot of things that go on today in some families. We were brought up Catholic in a very religious family, not overly religious, but religious enough. And my father was reasonably strict, keeping me towing the line. And so he's really my my hero, as well as my mother, who in those days kind of mother brought up most of the family anyway, as far as the children were concerned. So they did a good job.
Robert Modrzejewski attended the University of Wisconsin, where he was a member of the Marine Corps Platoon Leaders Class. Upon graduation in 1957, he was commissioned a second lieutenant. By 1966, he was in Vietnam, serving as commanding officer in the 3rd Battalion of the 4th Marines. In June of that year, he was to take part in Operation Hastings, an action that aimed to stop the North Vietnamese from infiltrating into the South through the demilitarized zone and Laos.
The operation started out as a helicopter assault, and then my company had initially 4 helicopters in the initial attack. So when we got to the landing zone, we started to take some small arms fire. So because the helicopter landing zone was too small to accommodate the 4 helicopters, 2 of them got too close together and crashed and started to burn, and some of the Marines who were trying to get out of the helicopter were killed. So it wasn't a very auspicious beginning. But once my unit landed, then we started to take off for our objective, which was about, oh, I guess 1,500 meters away from where we landed. And that was to be our blocking position.
Shortly after landing, the company encountered a well-entrenched enemy force. Modrzejewski led his men in a successful routing of the enemy and the seizure of a large quantity of ammunition and supplies. That evening, after reaching their position and setting up a perimeter, the group repelled an enemy counterattack. This marked the beginning of a battle that would continue over the next 4 days and 3 nights.
What happened is they were getting stronger all the time while I was getting weaker from casualties, lack of ammunition, the fact that we were surrounded for most of the time that we were there, and the fact that I couldn't get reinforced with other Marines because they were busy elsewhere. But we couldn't evacuate the dead or any of the seriously wounded because the jungle was so massive that there was no helicopter landing area that you could land a helicopter for him to take out your dead or your wounded. And then on the 3rd night, again, we were attacked by a battalion-sized force of enemy. So now it's about 500-1 against us, because by this time I've got probably about 100 Marines that are capable of fighting. And this lasted a long time into the night.
Massively outnumbered and surrounded, Modrzejewski skillfully directed artillery fire within close range of his position with devastating effect on the enemy. At one point, he managed to crawl 200 meters through heavy enemy fire to provide ammunition to an exposed element of his command.
And then on the 4th day, my battalion commander called me up and told me that the battalion's going to move to another area. And he wanted me to be the rear guard of the battalion. I told the battalion commander, I said, I don't have enough Marines here to protect the little sisters of the poor, let alone protect the rear of the battalion. But nevertheless, that was my mission. And we moved back about 1,500 yards. And then as soon as we got back to the landing zone where the 2 helicopters had crashed, out of the hills comes all these whistles and screaming and mortars going off and machine guns and everything else. And all these North Vietnamese, about 1,000 of them, were coming out of the hills. The only way we were able to survive was we called in airstrikes very close to our position that dropped napalm right in front of us. In fact, we had some of the Marines get singed because the napalm was so close. And we had artillery come in almost on top of our positions. Some of our Marines got hit with some artillery fragments. And again, it came down to not quite hand-to-hand combat, but very, very close. This went on for about 4 hours, and finally, for some unknown reason, the North Vietnamese just kind of picked up and went back into the hills. So we were very fortunate, and so after that, essentially, we moved with the rest of the battalion and caught up with them and went to a new position. I learned about receiving the Congressional Medal of Honor when I was stationed at Annapolis at the Naval Academy in Maryland. I was the commanding officer of the Marine Barracks, and one day my commanding officer, who was a Navy captain of the Naval Station, informed me that I was going to get the Medal of Honor. I never looked at it as something that belonged to me personally. Was always for the wounded and those that died and the sacrifices that they made. And it's hard to not go to the Vietnam Wall in Washington, D.C. and experience that and not become very emotional. There's just something about it. It's a very emotional place. We fight for the freedom of this country, for the freedom of the citizens of this country. It doesn't matter what war you're in. War is war is war. We owe sacrifices to the millions of men and women who have sacrificed their lives for this country. Nevertheless, I'm the guy wearing it, you know, for them.